Representative Clyde, you are now recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. You know, first, let me comment on my Democratic colleague from Georgia's statement on his assertion that the Democrats had wins for the American people. Well, let me go through a few of those wins. 40-year high inflation, wide open borders, rampant crime, and soaring energy costs. These are the Democrat wins. These are the big Democrat wins, but they're not for the American people. They're for the Democrats. But I rise to speak in support of H. Res. 1243. This resolution provides Congress with necessary information to review and address apparent conflicts of interest regarding President Joe Biden and members of his family. Without the ability to review documents held by the United States Treasury, such as suspicious activity reports, information which was previously routinely provided to Congress until the Biden administration, without the ability to review these documents, we cannot carry out proper congressional oversight. Hunter Biden's Chinese business deals are just one concern. In 2012, as Joe Biden and Barack Obama ran for re-election, Hunter and his longtime business partner, Devin Archer, now sentenced for fraudulent activities, reportedly entered talks with a Jonathan Lee, a Chinese national who ran Bohai Capital. The group founded private equity fund Bohai Harvest RST-BHR, and BHR is Biden Hunter Robert. On December the 16th, 2013, 11 days after Vice President Biden flew to Beijing to meet with President Xi Jinping, Hunter told The New Yorker he had explicitly requested to join Vice President Biden, his father, on the trip and arranged for Lee to meet his father. The New York Times reported that Hunter, Archer, and Christopher Heintz served on the board and controlled 30% of BHR. The rest of the company is owned and or controlled by Chinese investors that include the Bank of China, according to records filed with Chinese regulators. In 2016, BHR, through funds that came entirely from Chinese state-backed companies, contributed over $1 billion to the buyout of Arizona-based Freeport McMoRan for the purchase of a cobalt copper mine and copper mine in the Democratic Republic of Congo, when my good friend Mr. Donalds talked about cobalt. Hunter Biden stood to gain millions on the deal. The firm also purchased a stake in China's contemporary Amperex technology company, the world's biggest maker of batteries for electric vehicles. Committee Republicans have already written to the Transportation Secretary about our concerns that due to the Biden administration's policies, American jobs are suffering. For example, Ford Motor Company recently announced that it will cut 8,000 more American jobs. As Republicans highlighted in our January letter to the National Archivist, the American people deserve answers on the extent of Hunter Biden's business dealings, both domestic and abroad, and whether, or really how much, then Vice President Joe Biden was aware of the extent to which his son was trading on President Biden's name or Vice President Biden's name. Thank you, and I yield back.